Hello students, welcome to RCET Online. In this session, we'll be dealing with Module 5 of Cryptography and Cybersecurity from Semester 8 of Information Technology branch. Myself, Nikhila from Rajagiri School of Engineering and Technology. In this session, we'll be continuing Module 5 of Cryptography. And the topics that are discussed here are Diffie-Hellman key exchange protocol, how the key is being generated, and how Diffie-Hellman can be used to share a secret key between two communicating parties, and the principle behind Elgamal crypto system, how it can be used to find a digital signature. All these things are being discussed in this session. As we have already seen in the part 1 of module 5, there are three main applications for a public key crypto system. The first application is encryption and decryption of the message. We have already seen that RSA can be used for encryption and decryption of the message. And the second application is key exchange. And the third application is generation of digital signature. RSA can be even used for key exchange as well as generation of digital signature. Here we are going to define an algorithm called as Diffie-Hellman key exchange, which is exclusively used for key exchange. The purpose of the algorithm is to enable two users to securely exchange a key that can then be used for subsequent symmetric encryption of messages. The Diffie-Hellman algorithm depends for its effectiveness on the difficulty of computing discrete logarithms. For any integer b and a primitive root a of a prime number p, we can find the unique exponent I such that b is congruent to a raised to I mod p. The exponent I is referred to as a discrete logarithm of b for the base a and the modulus p. In Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm, there are two publicly known numbers, a prime number q and an integer alpha that is a primitive root of q. Suppose a user A and B wish to create a shared key. User A selects a random integer xA which is less than q and computes yA which is equal to alpha raised to xA mod q. Similarly, B independently selects a random integer XB which is less than Q and computes YB which is equal to alpha raised to XB mod Q. Each side keeps the X value private and makes the Y value available to public. Thus, XA is A's private key and YA is A's corresponding public key, and similarly for B. The user A computes the secret key as K which is equal to YB whole raised to XA mod Q, and user B computes the key K which is equal to YA whole raised to XB mod Q. Both the secret key that is generated at A and B will be the same. This slide shows how the same secret key is being generated at both A and B. That is, a key generated at both A and B will be the same. We have tried to explain the Diffie-Hellman protocol using an example. The main security issue that is being faced by Diffie-Hellman is man-in-middle attack. Here there are two communicating parties, Alice and Bob, that are trying to generate a secret key. And Darth is a third person who is trying to intercept the messages. When Alice wants to send something to Bob, Alice first shares the public key of Alice to Bob. When Alice tries to transmit the public key of Alice to Bob, Darth in between comes and intercepts the message and transmits Darth's public key instead of Alice's public key. Bob generates his public key and passes it to Alice. In between, Darth intercepts that message too and sends his public key instead of Bob's public key to Alice. Alice calculates her own secret key and Bob calculates his own secret key based upon the public key that is being sent by Darth intercepting the message that is being sent between Alice and Bob. Now Darth will be receiving all the messages that is being transmitted between Alice and Bob's and Bob, and Darth can intercept, decrypt, encrypt all the forward messages between Alice and Bob. AML crypto system is also a public key scheme based upon discrete logarithms. The AML crypto system is used in some form in a number of standards, including the digital signature standards. As with Diffie-Hellman, the global elements of AlGaMal are a prime number Q and alpha, which is a primitive root of Q. User A generates a private public key pair as follows. Generate a random integer XA, compute YA, which is equal to alpha raised to XA mod Q. A's private key is XA and A's public key is a combination of Q, alpha and YA. Any user B that has access to A's public key can encrypt a message as follows. The message is represented as integer M. Choose a random integer K such that K lies between 1 and Q minus 1. Compute a one-time key K, that is capital K, which is equivalent to YA raised to small k mod Q. Encrypt the message M as a pair of integers C1 and C2, where C1 is equal to alpha raised to small k mod Q, and C2 is equal to capital K into capital M mod Q. User A recovers a plain text as follows. Recover the key by computing K is equal to C1 whole raised to XA mod Q and compute M is equal to C2 into K inverse mod Q. Here comes a diagrammatic representation of AlGaMal cryptographic system, how the encryption and decryption has taken place in AlGaMal cryptographic system is depicted in the figure. In this session, we have dealt with Module 5 of Cryptography and Cybersecurity. Here, we have dealt with AlGaMal cryptographic system and Diffie-Hellman cryptographic system, their uses, how key generation is possible, and how encryption and decryption is done.